Ladakh has always been a cold, high-altitude desert. Farming and livelihoods where we depend on glacial meltwaters have never been easy. Add to that climate change. Glaciers that were very close to the villages have now receded far up. There's smaller and smaller mass of it. It's shrinking. The water situation has become even more erratic. Sometimes it's floods, sometimes it's droughts, more extremes. Our lifeline is disappearing, and therefore the need for the people to adapt, to innovate, and to find new ways of dealing with these hardships. This solution that we are working on, the ice stupa artificial glaciers, is about freezing the water that goes unused in winter into cones of ice. Because of this geometric shape, it doesn't melt till late spring, you know, May, June. Now that's the time when people are dying for every drop of water. Imagine that the bucket there is the source of water. So we take a pipe upslope, put it in the stream or the lake, bury it 6 feet under the ground, and the pipe takes water downslope to the village or the desert where we want to green or plant trees. Because of the gravity, pressure builds up in the pipe. Then water comes out gushing like this. Now this sprinkling water, when it mixes with minus 20 air, it falls down and freezes. Over weeks, it becomes a huge mountain of ice. We started piloting the ice stupa in real-life application. People of the village came and volunteered to plant 5,000 trees, which were supported in the lean months by the moisture from the ice stupa. And that is a proof of concept. We should not stop at that. We will have 50 or so large ice stupas, which will then feed trees that we plant. We should go beyond just solving it into turning it into an opportunity to green the deserts that were never greened by our ancestors.
The two lakes are here and here, and the ice stupas will be also along the mountains.
So using the land that's greened by one such solution to establish an institute that researches systematically, scientifically, finds solutions to problems that mountain people face now. We Ladakhis are the frontier to face climate change. We have to be resilient, clever enough, innovative enough to adapt to these changes so that our younger generation is ready to survive and flourish in these mountains.